I urge all members to come forward and participate. We have transformed ourselves from number-crunching statisticians to a value creator and to finally partner in nation building. The ICAI's punchline, ICAI, partner in nation building, was influenced by the words of wisdom spoken by President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. And taking inspiration from this, I plead to my fellow members in Kuwait, let us be partners in chapter building. Now, some anecdote here. It says that behind every successful auditor, there is an article. In its literal sense too, on occasion of CA Day, we decided to revive the previously discontinued e-letter Jagruti, the awakening. I'm extremely excited and thrilled, and so is the entire editorial team. I take this opportunity to congratulate the editorial team of the e-newsletter Jagruti for their amazing and relentless efforts in bringing out the first issue in such a short time. We call upon our auditors and accountants to contribute articles for upcoming newsletter editions. And hence, we call you that behind every successful auditor, there is an article. Gautam Buddha has said, I never see what has been done. I only see what remains to be done. Let us work hard and give our best. Let us act with our conscience and profess with accountability and integrity. I would like to thank you all for being with us and part of our illustrious journey at Kuwait Chapter. May I now request CA Shriram Gopalkrishnan, our secretary and part of the editorial team, to say a few words. And then we cut the virtual cake, launch the e-newsletter, and hear our distinguished guests. Over to you, Shriram. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Kaiser. It's really an honor. Let me start with a few lines that we managed to put together in an artistic way, right, as a poem. Come, let's unite. Come, let's unite and wake up knowledge. Wake up to knowledge. Wake up to wisdom. See what's right. Wake up to power. Wake up to beauty. Wake up to beauty. Lo and behold, ya esha supteshu jagrati. Respected President, CA Shri Atul Kumar Gupta ji. Respected Padma Shri CA Shri TN Manoharan ji. And my dear professional colleagues, namaste to all and a very happy CA Day to one and all, everybody. It is indeed a great honor to address the August gathering here this evening on behalf of the editorial board of our beloved chapter. Ever since our glorious institute was set up in July 1, 1949, our profession has grown leaps and bounds to acquire a much coveted position worldwide. It's not just within our country, but wherever you go around the globe, we hold a coveted position and we put our head up with pride looking at that. In the last 71 years, we have evolved from a simple, probably a number-crunching statistician, perhaps, to a value creator. And now, we are a partner in nation building and wherever we go. That is the level of evolution that we have had. Talking about our own chapter, as rightly mentioned by Kaiser, 19th April 2006, we had the privilege of formally inaugurating and by the then president, CA Shri T. Padma Shri T. N. Manoharan ji. And today we are all glad to have him among us when we are actually going through this very important milestone of our chapter. It's another feather we would claim in our caps, and we are very, very happy to have you here, sir. The same token, I would like to thank CA Shri Atul Gupta ji also. We had him last year in our Kuwait chapter, where another historic moment where we had a signing of the KAAA agreement with the local chapter here, with the local country's premier institution equivalent to our CA Institute. And it was very glad. I had the opportunity to interact with to CA Atul Gupta ji, and I'm very happy that he's among us today to again inaugurate the CAE newsletter for us, which is a very good milestone, you know, for us in our chapter here. Coming to a newsletter, like currency, knowledge also derives its value only if it is put in circulation. It is with this thought that we decided that we will launch our own e-newsletter. A very important objective in this newsletter is to closely bind our members beyond the, you know, the framework which is formal, beyond a formal framework, and reach out to the families of all our members too. Now, this is basically to uphold the true value of being one big family that we are. So in order to achieve this objective, we have decided to publish not only technical matters, but also articles and extracurricular matters, not only from members, but also from the spouse and the children of all our members. So that is one step where we took in order to make sure that we closely knit all the families of members present here in Kuwait. I take great pleasure in introducing the first editorial board of our newsletter. The alphabetical order it goes: CA Andalip Girkar, CA Kriti Bukasia, CA Navin Bora, CA Rohit Agarwal, CA Shweta Chipra, and CA Trisha Dalmia. Thanks to this first editorial team, we have been able to put together the newsletter. In fact, a very short amount of time, and you know, bring it up to the position that it can be launched today. Our team also wishes to place on record our thanks to the German press, who have been supporting all our publications for a continual period and putting up with all our, you know, getting caught with one CA for corrections is quite sufficient, and they are now dealing with a big editorial board full of chartered accountants, and you can imagine the kind of corrections we throw on them, and they were patient enough to put everything together and give it to us. Thank you so much. See, ultimately, the success and future of our profession depends entirely upon the conscientious efforts of our young CA generation. And as you would have noticed, our newsletter too, our newsletter and the editorial board is also staffed with all young minds to add this recipe of youth newsletter, right? With a request to all members and their families to contribute in large number of articles to our beloved e-newsletter to keep it alive and interesting and useful. Jai Hind.
Rohit, Deepak would now like to start the proceedings.
So I will introduce Mr. President Atul Gupta ji, CA Shri Atul Gupta ji. A man with clear vision and respected for his down-to-earth approach at the issues at hand among his professional colleagues. And I had an opportunity to meet him last year in our Kuwait chapter international event. And I can vouch for his down-to-earth approach. Also, I learned when you light a lamp, you have to remove your shoes. So, you know, you can learn small things from CA Atul Gupta ji. So Atul ji has been elected as the president of ICAI for the term 2021, having served the profession for about two decades. He joined the Central Council of ICAI in 2013. Since then, he has been member of many important committees constituted by the government and the regulatory bodies. For example, Government Accounting Standards Advisory Board and Audit Advisory Board. Atul ji has immensely contributed as a facilitator of the goods and service tax regime. Under his leadership, new scheme of education and training was launched in 2017 with the comprehensive revision of the content of the study materials of intermediate and final level courses. I'm sure it must have gone through a sea change compared to the time I did my CA in 92 to 95. And that is a good sign that the CA course has been evolving with the changes in the time. Thanks to the members of the Central Council and the President. On international front, he is board member of the South Asian Federation of Accountants, which is called SAFA, member of the Public Sector Management Committee of the Confederation of Asian and Pacific Accountants, CAPA, and representing ICAI in International Integrated Reporting Council, IIRC. Atulji has authored many relevant books and published numerous articles in newspapers and magazines, and he has delivered lectures in about 1,500 seminars and conferences. And we are honored and happy and lucky to have him with us, and we will get to know from him some points of pearls of wisdom. So I hand over to Sri Atulji. Please help me welcome CA Sri Atul Kumar Gupta ji, the President of ICAI.
Thank you, Deepak bhai. The Honorable Vice Chairman of the chapter and Honorable Past President CA TN Manoharan sir, CA Kajar, Army man, become Chartered Accountant, the Chairman of chapter, and Sri Ram, Sri Ram Gopalakrishnan ji, at the outset, I convey my deep regards to all of you and a happy CA Day to all of you on this 72nd Foundation Day of ICAI. And you all will agree that we have completed our glorious journey of 71 years. Journey of independence, integrity. And with me, our profession started with only a few hundred members and the students. Today, we have more than 350,000 members, more than 7 lakh students. And even out of 350,000 members, more than 40,000 members are now located overseas like you and taking the flag of the profession to the newer height. Friends, I just wish to share with you that the Institute started with only one office. Today we have more than 165 branches in India, and including the representative office which we started this year. So we have more than 35 chapters and the 15 representative office today. So practically the Institute is having the presence of in around 35 countries outside India. Friends, you will also take note of this aspect that the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is rightly being called as a catalyst of a socio-economic reform, because in a fees of less than $1,000, if and with a 3-year rigorous training, somebody is having the career like I can just see, for example, the Deepak Bhai or Kaiser ji or even Manoharan sir, maaf kijiyega sir, Manoharan sir, just to share with you that with a very small fees, with a rigorous training, today in a starting package of a chartered accountant is raising from 8 lakhs to 20 lakhs at the domestic level. We can become the large scale practitioners. We can become the practitioners, we can join the industry with that kind of a package, and even we can become the civil service servant. You must have witnessed that yesterday we were having a program where all the IPS, IAS, IRS, IFS officers participated, including the Honorable Justice Vinit Kothari ji from the Chennai High Court. So all are the chartered accountants. So how, you can see that I will say without any sources, without any resources and so. Even the last person of this lowest strata person can become a chartered accountant and fulfill its dreams. Even as a women empowerment, today we have the more than 40%, 41% is the girls students, and 27% plus is the membership based, which are belongs to the women member. Friends, it is rightly mentioned by Kajar bhai that the Institute is always known as a partner in nation building, because whether it is any new law is there in the country or any new process or any new scheme is there, the chartered accountants are playing a very, very important role. And even in this kind of a pandemic situation, the institute is playing a very important role. And we recently launched a scheme to even to support the MSME sector, apart from the other initiative of the rebooting the Indian economy and bringing more and more investment into the India. Now, friends, when we are talking about the international affairs, I just wish to share with you the various initiatives taken by the ICI. And I believe that you are the part of that initiative because you are already there in this country from so long, and you are cherishing the contribution of the ICI vis-a-vis the entire ecosystem, which is providing the necessary support to be successful in this particular part of the globe. Friends, you are aware that we started the journey when we were having only the one head office, but after that we entered into the number of MRAs. So today we have the 7 MRAs available with ICI, which is actually becoming the international gateway for our students, our members, that once you qualify the CA examination, you are at par with the 7 more jurisdictions in the England and Wales. You are not required to appear in any paper. In some jurisdiction, you have to appear in one paper and you can have the qualification from them as well. Even I just wish to tell you that there are a large number of unilateral recognition of the profession as well. Recently, I was searching and you will be surprised to know that in the Mauritius Act, that is the section 51A of the Mauritius Act talks about that who can be the recognized, who all are recognized in the Mauritius Act to be the having the license of practice. And you will find that in the third place, they have mentioned the member of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Then I went through for some other African countries and I found that the equal kind of a recognition is there in many of the countries across the globe, which is called as a unilateral recognition. Meaning thereby that once you are a chartered accountant, you are not a chartered accountant for the India. You are chartered accountant practically for more than 20 plus countries as a practitioner. And what to talk about that when you are there in the industry. Today, our members, when we are doing a lot of activities and lot of initiative to become create the more and more representative office, you will find, I just try to find out, and we find that in even more than 100 countries, in the times to come, we will be able to create our own chapters or the rep office because we have the presence in all these countries. Friends, the institute is taking a number of initiatives to get our qualification more and more recognized. You are aware that the last year we got the NARIC recognition, which is a UK-based equivalency agency, which talks about the RQF level 7, which means that our qualification at the UAE, at the Middle East, as well as in the UK, in the Canada or some other part of the globe, is equivalent to the master degree for the one or the other purposes, whether it is for doing some other courses or for even for taking the audit license or for the other some other purposes. Friends, you will also note that we have taken the recently various new initiative. We have already the office available in Dubai, and now we are moving the new office in Singapore. And very soon we are also planning to initiate the process to have the office in USA as well. Side by side, we are also working on the international curriculum. Honorable T.N. Manoharan sir is a part of that special group which is working on the international curriculum. And I believe that by this year end, we will be able to reach to that position, that we will be having a very near to the, either we will be implementing the international curriculum or we will be very near to that implementation. And by virtue of that, not only our students who hails from the India or who are the kids of the Indian chartered accountants, there will be the other colleagues, there will be the other students from the different jurisdiction and specifically from the developing countries will be joining the ICI course as a student of the ICI rather than only as a kids of the chartered accountant or who is from the hails from India. Likewise, I just wish to share with you, in the yesterday meeting, the council approved the foreign policy of the ICI, and we will be sharing you that particular very important document which talks about the vision of the ICI, that by 2024, we are aspiring to be there in the 100 countries and with a strong base of the more than 40,000 members who are already there in the different part of the jurisdiction. So friends, there are a lot of initiatives taken by the ICI to make this profession really global. And I'm very happy that in the presence of T.N. Manoharan sir, you will be launching this e-newsletter, which will be a very important source of information as well as update to all the colleagues. As rightly mentioned by Kaiser bhai, that one is the article means the apprentice, one is the article means the article for the research paper for the knowledge. So there will be a lot of knowledge being shared through the e-newsletter. I compliment all the chapters and specifically your chapter for putting a lot of efforts for the cause of the profession, for the benefit of the profession, and for the benefit of the chartered accountants and their family members at the one or the other occasion. I just wish to convey you that we at the ICI is available to you for 24/7 at the grassroots level. As Deepak bhai mentioned, that I am a down-to-earth personality. The entire profession is like this. If you will ask me that the TN Manoharan sir is such a huge personality, that today he is the CM, chairman of the Canara Bank, and is a Padam Shri, is holding so many important position, but still he is available at night at 9 o'clock. And even I will say the further humility of this sir, that even he allowed me to speak before him, so that kind of profession we are. So it's like I'm implementing the wheel of at least for this particular e-newsletter. And I believe in the times to come, there will be a lot of initiatives under your able leadership. I just wish to request you one more important task, that we are entering into the large number of MOUs at here and there. But it is not important to enter into the MOU. With a more strong relationship, more positive relationship, more useful relationship and productive relationship, that is the key of getting the success of the MOU rather than only signing the MOU. So my urge to you that even if, say for example, there is a today's program, you please invite the KAAA person, you involve them, you organize the joint programs with them, you participate with them, you give the training to their colleagues of the KAAA, so that there will be much more stronger relationship with the KAAA and will be useful in the times to come. I just wish to convey you that on the 6th of July, the Foreign Secretary of the IC, Foreign Secretary of the Government of India will be addressing all the chapters of the ICI, all the 50 chapters of the ICI on that particular day at the Indian time at 5 o'clock. And we have raised number of us to create a more harmonious relationship with the MEA, so that there will be a kind of a collaboration of the MEA and the Ministry of Commerce and ICI, and including the SCPC. We have recently entered into the agreement MOU with the Service Export Promotion Council. So practically we are trying to see that how ICI will be as a nodal agency around the MEA, Ministry of Commerce, SCPC and all the Chamber of Commerce, so that practically we can become a force, and not only for the various initiative of the Government of India, but also bringing the investment in India, making more and more exports from India and making our country a vibrant, developed country in the times to come. Thank you very much to all of you for giving me this opportunity. Thanks to Honorable Past President T.N. Manoharan sir for blessing all the time. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. It was indeed enlightening and informative, your speech as always. We look forward to, I know, like, you know, we are short of time, and that's we are not able to give you much time. Having said that, about the KAAA, like, you know, gotten. I'm sorry, I think I lost the connection.
Yeah, continue.
Yeah, so like, you know, we have connected with KAAA, and we have of the initiatives, and we've told them like, you know, how best we can collaborate and exchange of information on doing courses together. In an earlier statement of what transforms us, 65 or 300, see the 375 to 14,000 is definitely says it all. With that, may I now request, Atulji, to officially cut the virtual cake for the CA Day celebration. Of course, you would have loved to have an actual cake and put on some weight, but we can't do that right now, given the situation, and launch the e-newsletter. Deepak? Rohit?
Yeah.
We are on diet, so we are not eating, that's why.
Over to you, Kaiser.
Yeah. May I now take the opportunity, and it's my privilege actually to be welcome.